hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. They'll set up to throw. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
On first and 10, it's ETN. Oh, what a move. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. Jeff Gladney able to come up and make the tackle. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. A shotgun snap, and again the ETN runs over it. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Now they'll try the jet sweep here. Ooh, the juke. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3.
So this game, Charles, you know, we talk about potential unbeaten seasons a lot. It feels like every year at some point in the season we talk about that. But this is one of those games where if you're unbeaten, you got to be careful. You can't take this one too lightly.
You're exactly right about that. And by rights, this should be a cakewalk. Almost a week off. Let the starters run up the score in the first half. Backups get to play in the second. But you and I both know the funny things sometimes happen when you think this way. So it's incumbent upon the starters to really play well to make it work for this team.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. And the Lions are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door. First and goal. ETN. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Noah Gray, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Lions take it right down and score on the opening drive. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Bears now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by a first-round pick back in 2021 from Ohio State. It's Justin Fields.
Would you say that last week's performance by him, workmanlike in terms of numbers?
One touchdown, one pick, but obviously a loss.
Yeah, that's the bottom line for him. All he cares about is how do we find a way to win the game. Maybe leans on a few other parts of the offense,
and hopefully springs a receiver or two free.
On the move to his left, and he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Cameron Hayward able to collapse the pocket, get to him, and drop him for a loss of a yard.
It may be cliche, but it is something that holds up over time, doesn't it? If you're the visitors, you don't want to let the crowd in the game early.
Yeah, and that's exactly what they did there. But you said also this defense, they're going to give them a lot of looks like we just saw there, aren't they?
They certainly are. They're a proud unit, and they're going to ride the momentum of this crowd with them, and that's why they got after them early.
Second and 11 now. Another try after the first down sack. Fields looking sideline, incomplete.
Well, Charles, this Thanksgiving tradition, so great. I mean, going back essentially through the full century of the NFL, I know you probably have a lot of fond memories of Thanksgiving Day football yourself.
I certainly do, and I don't have the Turkey Bowl tradition. You know, the families that go out and play and then come in and sit down to their feast and watch football. But I remember reading about, remember the Lions jumping on the Packers on Thanksgiving Day, the only loss the Packers had in 1962, and they sacked Bart Starr over 10 times in that game. And I remember Dave Williams from the Bears returning the overtime kickoff for a touchdown to win a game on Thanksgiving Day. I remember so many different things happening, but how much fun is it each and every year to know that you've got football on Thanksgiving Day?
They will run for the first time with David Montgomery. And for a second straight play, the Lion defense drops him behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and four coming up.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
DB here on third down. Now it's Fields. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth. On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Here's J.K. Scott set to do the punting honors. He punted four times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked out and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
Back onto the field come the Lions for their second overall drive. And they will begin with, should we call it, far from ideal starting field position, their own 2-yard line.
So what's your definition of ideal?
The 1-yard line on the other side of the field.
Yes, exactly right. So yes, your definition is apropos in this case.
And he's able to get him a small cushion before being taken down at the 5, a gain of 3. The last run got 3, now here's 2nd and 7. Running out of the gun with ETN. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5. They're going to look to throw. I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there as that's batted down and incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get now a hit and a loose football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. He's at the 30, 10, and into the end zone. A scoop and score on the fumble return for the Detroit touchdown.
So that's about as fortuitous of a bounce as you're going to find as it's scooped up and take it in for the touchdown.
And I love how you use the word fortuitous there, because as that popped up, he just happened to be in the right place, grabbed it, and found his way into the end zone.
Koo now for the point after. And it's good to make it 14-0. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. So here's the kickoff now, as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. And they, almost to a man, told us how excited they are to be playing in this traditional Thanksgiving game. But we have to remember, this is a team that lost on Sunday. Now they get a very quick turnaround to play again. How difficult is that to do?
It's difficult under any normal circumstance when you're coming off of a loss and you have a quick turnaround. The first thing is to put the loss behind you and move forward. But when you plan on Thanksgiving Day, everyone's watching you. It's an added bonus, though, because now you put the loss behind you. Get that taste out of your mouth, because the taste you want is victory, turkey, and pumpkin pie.
Following the penalty, Montgomery. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
Well behind the sticks here with a second and 18. Here's Fields. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And this is scooped up by the Lions. And he's going to get this on down to the 13-yard line. He was under duress, surveying, trying to find somebody to get the ball out of his hands. In the meantime, the defense, they took it out of his hands.
And when the ball snapped, I know exactly what the defense is thinking. Get a sack, put him on the ground. But when you can also knock the ball free while doing so, oh, there's the bonus for you as a defender.
Detroit's offense ready to take over. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, they could really put them in command before intermission.
Yeah, and it's all well and good what they're seeing and how they're feeling right now. But this is the NFL. How many times have we watched 14-0 leads evaporate and quickly? So how have we seen them combat it? Continue to run your offense, but don't back off at all. Don't start looking at the clock. Don't start thinking about, hey, just take care of the football. Keep attacking. Usually the best way to maintain control.
And a nice pick up there. It gets about five down to the 4-yard line. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Looking for Hockenson, and he's got him. Touchdown, Detroit. T.J. Hockenson, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Lions add on to their lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. He finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Now Younghoe Koo for the extra point. And it is now 21-0. The drive there only spanning three plays. And the end result, a Detroit touchdown. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
You know, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It'll only be a loss of a couple, but the pressure gets home on first down.
He continues, Charles, to be under constant pressure. These sacks, they're starting to pile up.
If they want to have a realistic chance in this one, they've got to change their blocking assignments. They've got to do a better job to keep him upright. If he's going to be on the deck constantly, they've got no chance to win this game.
Now following the sack, they'll come up here on a second down and 12. Now Fields. Dancing to his left. And he'll slide to a halt here. Still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3. But now it's third down. To throw his Fields. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Lions have recovered. So now 2 fumbles lost here in this first half.
Not setting the pace the way that you want it done. I mean, here in the first half, already twice the ball's come out and hit the turf. Got to find a way to take care of it. Otherwise, they may have to start thinking about maybe someone different at that position.
A handoff for ETN. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Second and 6. They'll try and set up the screen to ETN. Give him 3 on the screen. He couldn't break free, and it's third down.
Boy, that was certainly well-read defensively. And the key to any screenplay is space to work. And there was none to be found there. And they tackle him for just a short gain.
Out of the gun now on third down. He finds his man, complete. That's Gardner. And he is going to have a Lions first down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on 3rd and 3.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. It'll only be a loss of a couple, but the pressure gets home on first down.
Well, that's what they have to do more of defensively, not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face, not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey.
Second and 12.
They'll set up a throw. Flush to his right. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds, right around the 7. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for third. They'll look to throw. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. And his kick is good. And the rout is on. It's 24 to nothing. So everything else has gone right in this first half. Kind of follows that it would for their kicker, too, as he adds three more onto the lead.
Yeah, and the way that this one's gone, definitely not looking like he's going to have to worry too much about pressure kicks late in the game. He can go out there free and easy, just work on his form, and he knocked that one through.
And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Here comes Justin Fields and the rest of the Bears offense. And he has not really been able to have a lot of comfort back there in the pocket. Pressure's been coming at him a lot, hasn't it?
And they've got to figure out how to tamp down that pressure. How do they decrease it? Is it getting rid of the football quicker? You know, shorter drops? Maybe they do something different with their pass blocking and their protection schemes. Maybe you meet them on the line of scrimmage instead of retreating to try and protect your quarterback. They've got to figure something out, though, because you cannot let your guy get hit that much. Not if you intend to win.
Yeah, I know they'd like to erase that video and those four sacks that they've seen so far. Second and seven. Play action. It's Fields. A throw left side taken in by Kmet. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, here's Fields. He'll get this underneath to Montgomery. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. So we're at halftime here on the annual Thanksgiving game in Detroit. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And a happy Thanksgiving to everybody out there. As we look ahead to two more games later today, and then a full slate coming up this weekend. Plenty to look forward to in that early window. One being a noontime start up in Green Bay. A big one for the Packers, as they'll have to contend with the visiting Pittsburgh Steelers. Good games in the late afternoon as well, one being out in Santa Clara, where it'll be the 49ers taking on the Seattle Seahawks. And one more to highlight, a good one on Monday Night Football between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Denver Broncos. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Bears going to see the football first, and they trail here as we get back underway to start this second half. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Here comes Justin Fields and the rest of the Bears offense. He's playing pretty well. I don't think it's necessarily him changing up something he's doing, but that O-line, they've got to protect him better.
They do. They've got to make sure that they give him more than enough time in order to find targets downfield. And sometimes what happens when these things are going on is that the field general will step up and say, hey, that's on me, guys. I didn't get rid of it fast enough. Anything to try and relax them a little bit and take some pressure off, because they do know that they are trying.
Yeah, well, we've seen the four sacks so far in this contest. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. They'll keep pounding here with Montgomery. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. The third down now. Those last two plays indicative of how things have gone for them. Just nowhere to go on the ground and struggling to put up points. First, trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted. Picked up by J.C. Jackson. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. The first half did not go their way, and that's not going to help matters at all. An interception here on the opening drive of the third quarter.
Obviously not what they were striving to accomplish, but you know who's really upset on their team? The defense. Already trailing, they're going to be counted on to try and hold that score at least where it is.
Here's a give to Etienne.
A beautiful fake. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Second and two. Throw over the middle, caught by the tight end Gray. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
They'll run with Etienne, able to slither by. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. A pickup of four on first down. It'll be second and goal.
And Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line. Because ordinarily...
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Travis Etienne, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Lions have got it on cruise control.
Could not block that one any better. Everyone was accounted for, and a great surge by the offensive line.
Coup for the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So that drive, four plays. And it was capped off by a Travis Etienne touchdown run. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. The Chicago offense set to get started.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
There's a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Fields now to throw.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Cameron Hayward attacking off the edge that time.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
So now following the sack, Fields and the Bears looking at third down and long.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw under pressure, and they got to him again.
Aline McNeil has now recorded 10 sacks on the season.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
They just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them.
Here's J.K. Scott now, standing just outside his own goal line. Call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and the Lions will take over. And Detroit getting set to go now. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. Now these two division rivals, a couple of late games on the schedule this year. Their first meeting, you might remember, was back in Week 10. And it was the Lions who got the road victory in that one. So they'll be looking to claim the season series now here at home in Detroit. Now it's the backup Stafford. Flushed out right. Open man, he's got him, the tight end Hockenson. Pushes him over, and he is out of bounds inside the 35. A big play there on the catch and run.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. And to give this time to the tailback. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 15-yard line. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Thanksgiving Day. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Now Stafford. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Johnson. And the Bears force the turnover. They'll take over at the 10. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it was a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well, protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
On first down, it's Fields. That's complete right side to Komet. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Fields. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
If he's their best threat on offense, use your number one cover guy on defense. It doesn't matter about size.
They have had him locked up. That just his first catch of the game. Big reason why they're down. Fields throw there, complete to Mooney. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. They'll come up now on 2nd and 1 yard. Throwing again is Fields.
looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
And Charles, you wonder about this defense coming in. I mean, look, it's no secret they're playing a team that's down on its luck right now. Losers of five straight. How does that change how you prepare for a game?
Bro, to me, the first thought is you just get after them early, right? Take away any chance of them building any confidence. But the second thing is you prepare a little bit differently. You've got to expect this team to take chances, go for it on third and fourth downs, run a lot of trick plays, anything to try and break their losing streak. So you must stay alert and stay aware.
Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. So the false start will back them up five.
False start for offense.
And that'll set them back five. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Back to throw. Fields. He'll buy some time right. And a five-yard gain gets him to the 42. The Bears on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be third and six. Here's Fields. Into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked up by J.C. Jackson. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Koo able to connect on the extra point, and the lead will swell by one more. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Another drive coming up for this Chicago offense. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. Throwing after the interception, Fields. It's complete. This is Starks. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Simple drag route here, lined up out left. He tried to work his way back across the field. You probably saw me twitch there, partner, because I think he wanted the ball a little bit sooner. By the time he looked it in, defender was right on him.
Meanwhile, Fields throw there, hauled in by Claypool. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
They'll roll him out right. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. To throw again on second down, Fields. And this will be caught by Mooney.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs as we just saw there.
And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. Used to be occasional, right, safety valve, throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
That's complete to Mooney. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Well, there have been a ton of sacks. They were just trying to prevent another.
So what you're telling me is the conventional way has not really worked for them, huh?
Not at all.
Not at all. So he tries to grab him here, and they still get caught.
Looking to throw. Fields. And his throw is incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Throwing on second and long. Fields. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Again, he'll drop to throw. He's going to let it fly. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Here's J.K. Scott now as he's on to punt for Chicago. Taken in at the 11. So holding there on the return, and that'll back him up to start the next drive.
Yeah, that's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the officials look in their manual and see the expression, jersey getting pulled, that's a flag coming out every time.
And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. Another example of this offense really having their way, Charles, and another big chunk play there on the ground.
And then when you look at the defense, they've got to do a much better job of wrapping up when they tackle. A lot of great opportunities continue to slip through their fingers, as do the runners.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Stafford gonna throw it. He's gonna rifle one deep left side. And that gonna be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Charles, thinking back to what you said in the first quarter, that part of the magic elixir for a road victory for these underdogs was going to be winning the turnover battle. Well, they only have one right now. Look at the scoreboard.
Yeah, not exactly playing to the form that I subscribed, right? When you talk about winning that turnover battle.
Launches deep. A jump ball, and this is caught. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. Now a first down throw, Stafford. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And that is incomplete. So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for Detroit, the streak continues as they push their mark to a perfect 12-0 now on the year. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Chicago, the season is beyond salvage now as they fall to 2-10. And they'll get the extra week to think about this one as they return to action in 2 weeks' time. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. Exclusive. Honorable words.
Empty, this mobile that came from my money is silly. I feel an envy, not trying to be friendly. It is what it is. If you want me, come get me. Whenever you ready, no, I keep it steady. Yeah, I get the W, throw the